For reals, but would you ever consider going to Showtime where there's better fights at 140 and 147?
I have my lana at Showtime.
For reals?
Yeah. I thought for reals.
Oh, it's a question for Brandon.
For Brandon. Yeah. We think Brandon's got a great manager, great promoter. I think he's got the best manager out there. We're very happy where we're at. That's his manager's business. You know, if his manager said, "Hey, I think we're moving over," then that'd be his decision. But right now, we're good where we're at.
From at Sadie, does Rios want to fight Ortiz?
He's not in our level, right? He's fighting on ESPN, or where he's fighting? Fox Sports? We fight on HBO. Oh.
Yeah.
We fight on HBO.
If Rios were to fight Pacquiao again, what would you do different?
Well, you know, there's always that, oh, you should have done this, you should have done that. Inside the ring, Pacquiao did what he had to do, fought a hell of a fight. He's very fast. He's very smart. He fought a good fight. What can we say, you know? After the fight, everybody, oh, Robert should have done this, should have done that, you know. Totally different, you know. What can I say?
From Don Flaviano. If you want to critique your own work, what would it be?
If I what?
You want to
criticize your own performances.
What would you say about yourself?
Like bad about myself?
Like what do you need to improve on?
Good or bad? You could do both.
Well, maybe what some people have said. But I wouldn't do it differently because we've been good. But maybe you know, all the fun that we have and play around and joke around. But hey, but look at where we're at. I think 2013 was a better year than 2012.
But that's what makes this gym unique, where everybody's not scared. Yeah. They're being themselves.
So
you gotta be yourself first.
So, you know, I think we have a great team with
you got Donald.
Everybody here with the whole family here. We made a fucking beautiful team, huh? Full of good supporters, great boxers, boxers that listen, boxers that support each other. What would I do different? I don't think I'd do anything different. I think because the way we do it is why we're here. So why would I change anything?
Danny Garcia versus Hector Camacho. Fantasy match. Who wins?
Okay, but which Danny Garcia? Because Hector Camacho was in the time that Danny Garcia, your uncle, was fighting. So maybe that one. Maybe that one, right? That's probably what they're talking about, right? Right?
Yeah.
Because that was in the same era. You know, Danny Garcia, your uncle, was fighting at around that same time. So maybe that one. Or Danny Garcia this time, like Danny Garcia from Philly.
Puerto Rico versus Puerto Rico.
I think Camacho, hey,
bad,
Camacho dude. Without boxing.
In
Camacho's prime, I think Camacho would beat him.
That's the last one.
Camacho was bad.
The other ones are
repeats.
That's smart. Hey, you heard what Mayweather said? What
did he say?
He said that if his fighter would suffer a knockout the way that Manny suffered, he would tell his fighter to retire.
You know what? He would tell him. I'm sure a lot of people told Manny to retire too. But then what we've heard and that Manny's having problems with money, tax, and all that. Maybe he's forced to fight. But he came back and fought fucking good. So can't blame him for coming back, right?
Yeah, no, you
he
have
took that year off, and I think that year off helped him fucking so much that motherfucker performed very well. Performed very well.
And if you're the fighter, you feel that you could continue. Do one
exactly.
More.
Why not? You know, a lot of fighters get knocked out and then they never come back, and then because they know they're not good. A lot of fighters think they're good and they come back and they get knocked out worse. The fuck?
But not only that, he made good money. If a fighter was making like $20,000,
yeah, you know, I would tell, I would definitely tell if one of our fighters, one of my four-round fighters, you know, not making money, gets knocked out that bad, then I'm like, you know what, maybe you shouldn't be fighting. But if they're making fucking $18 million a fight,
at least.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. And if they think they can win, yeah, and it's winnable.
And if he feels good, and hey, and then look at his performance. He felt fucking good. He looked strong. He looked quick. Why not continue?
Okay. If Manny fights Mayweather, who wins?
I think Mayweather wins.
Why?
I think Mayweather wins. Mayweather's just too smart. He's too fast. I think Manny, years ago I would say I thought Manny would win, but now I'd have to give it to Mayweather.
You agree?
I don't think Floyd would put himself in a position to go far.
And if I was Floyd, I wouldn't fight him. I was still making $50 million a fight. You know, he didn't want to fight, they didn't fight when, you know, when the fight should have happened. Why now? I wouldn't. Still making, you know, still gonna make $50 million.
He made 100 his last fight.
He made 100
his last fight. And he made 84 before that.
So, no, he doesn't have to fight them. He doesn't have to fight them.
He loses to Manny. That's,
yeah, and if he loses, imagine.
It's all good.
Well, anytime you step in the ring, there is a chance you might lose.
That's right. I wouldn't.
Even if he fights.
Just like Marquez, I wouldn't fight Manny anymore. Because you go in there, you might lose to Manny. And everybody's gonna forget the knockout.
You're right. Which is,
you know, if I was Marquez, well, hopefully he doesn't fight him. But you know, I would let 100 years from now everybody remember that guy knocked out.
That's the last thing gonna remember.
Yeah, that's the last thing gonna remember.
In the history of boxing, that knockout has to be among the best.
Yeah, it was.
So what happened to Bon Bon this weekend? Can we discuss it on camera or no?
Yeah, why not?
Bon Bon.
To my aunt in Fontana had a party. You don't know this, Mike?
So I guess when you're at this level, you know, like TMC comes up to you, shit happens. TMC is like.
So Mikey, this is what happened. I'm hearing this for the first time.
So he's over there at my aunt's house. So my mom and everybody, my Chela, they leave. And Chela leaves him right there with fucking
Richard and Manuel.
So they start drinking. They start getting drunk. By the end of the day, this motherfucker was wearing high heels.
I put on high heels.
I took them off.
But
you were wearing high heels.
Put high heels on your man.
Is that part of the blueprint?
One bone's
not. Nah, it's not part of the blueprint.
They were smoking that shit. What you call that shit they smoke? Gupa or whatever that shit is?
Buka.
Hey, they were smoking that shit and fucking drinking beer. And motherfuckers wearing high heels.
I knew it.
You know what I mean?
Bon Bon.
You thought about being with a man?
The fuck was that?
I,
you dance for your cousin?
I hit the table. Yeah. I hit one of these tables. I like stumbled. I tried going down. And boom!
Like right here on my eyebrows.
So what made you put on the eye heel?
We're talking about something.
Talking about something and wearing high heels? Doesn't make sense.
We're talking about like how they do marathons in high heels. And it's like all crazy where they take their fucking ankles and they run, you know, they sprint.
I've seen that on the news.
Some fucking fat girl was there and she told me that her high heels might bend. So I just put them on. I was like, fuck it.
Yeah.
And they actually,
hey, Mikey.
He was. Okay, wait, we'll cut this one. But he was on the same.
Marco. Hey, Bon Bon. If a girl, later, Bon Bon, if a girl has money, is that the only thing that matters to you?
I want a nice relationship, peaceful relationship.
Fuck you, we said 400.
I want them nice and cute, nice and peaceful, nice and, you know, for me.
So why are you bragging that this girl that you obviously didn't like, but you said, but she had money? Is money everything in life?
Yeah, money is everything in life.
Mikey, don't forget your hat.
All right.
Oh, you got it?
You can't do life without money.
Tomorrow's media day?
Yeah, you want to be here?
I'll be here.
You can't live life without money.